Okay, guys. So far we have talked about stress analysis, stress spotting, and different types of showing the stress result. In this lecture, we will talk about displacement plotting. We will talk about stress spotting. Then we will talk about fatigue analysis. Then we will talk about factor of safety analysis. So let's get started. So right after the stress plotting, we have displacement plotting. To show displacement plotting, we can right click on this and click on show. So here you can see it is showing us the displacement for this mathematical model here. And here in the legend, if you take a look at the legend, you can see the unit are in millimeter, and the red area is showing the maximum amount of displacement, and the blue area is showing the minimum amount of displacement right here. So if we compare this legend with the model right here, we can see that this is the area where the maximum amount of displacement occur for our model. So this is all about this is about displacement plotting. And now if we right click on here, and if you go to settings right here, we can see the options right here. We have the first fringe options. We can see change the fringe options as we want. If we want to make it point, that in then it will show us the point where the maximum amount of displacement happened, just like the before stress analysis. There it is showing, it is quite similar. Then if you click on the line will be shown. Then if we click on discrete, the model will be shown in discrete format, and we will go on continuous. Then in the next option, we have a option called here superimpose model on the deformed shape. So if we click on this, you can see here I will just increase the transparency right here. If we increase the transparency right here, it will show us the previous model, and the displacement will be superimposed over the previous model, as you can see right here. So this is what a superimposed model on that deformed shape does. I hope this is clear to you guys. If you want to show this model in this format, you can just click OK. I will just cancel this. Now we will talk about the animation showing the displacement. You can create a little animation in AVI files, AVI type of files, and show the result. To create animation, you will just simply click on right click on the displacement plot right here, and you will click animate. Then SolidWorks will automatically create the animation right here. As you can see, it is showing us the displacement animation. If you want, you can increase or decrease the frame rate for the video, or the you can make it slow and you can make it faster. And here right underneath that, we have save as AVI file. If you right click on it, then you can you will see that here is your option, and you can set the location where you can save the video right here. If we will save it right here in beginning, and we will give it a name, and displacement animation, and we will click save. So the video will be saved, and if you click on it, view with media player, we can right click on it and we can see the video right here. It will be shown as AIB. Maybe my video player has a little problem. So this is how you can create animation, and you can save it. Then you can watch it later or show it later to your teacher or to your boss whom you need to show it. So this is all about displacement plotting. I hope this is clear to you. And the next option is, as you can see here, this is strain. we will not talk about strain plotting. So to right click to show strain plotting, we will right click on it and we will click OK. As you can see, it is showing the elemental result right here, just like before in the stress analysis, when we clicked on elemental values. The difference, main difference between this strain plot here with the elemental value of stress is the elemental value was averaged on each element, but this value right here is not average, it is non-average value showing right here for this element right here. And in this region right here, you can see in stress analysis and in displacement analysis, we had units available in here, but we have no units available for strain analysis. It is just showing the value for each element. So this is stress and strain analysis, and you can right click on it and you can go to edit definition and you can change this and play with this as you want, just like I showed you before in the stress analysis. You can go to chart option, you can click on show maximum annotation, you can click on show minimum annotation, it will show you the areas, and then you can change the position of the legend, you can change the result how you want to show them. Like if you click on floating, it will show us in float. If you click on general, it will show us as general. If you click on scientific, if you click on scientific, it will show us the scientific value. So this is all about strain analysis. So just like click on it, and you can also animate the strain analysis. For example, here you can see the stress analysis has been animated. I forgot one thing. You can also you can also show. Let me click on show, and you can also animate the amount of stress applied on this model, and you can click save it as a AVI file also. So I will not save it. I will just close it. So this is all about stress displacement and strain analysis. Now we have we will talk about factor of safety. As you all know, factor of I hope you all know what is factor of safety. So what will be the factor of safety for this model right here for our applied load 11,000 newton? So let's talk about it, how we can show factor of safety plot right here. To do this, we will right click on result, and here you can see define factor of safety plot. So if you click on it, you will see here is an option. So the first one is how you want to show the factor of safety. We will click on automatic. Then you can set the upper limit for factor of safety, and you can click on it and you can set the upper limit. It will not show the upper limit above that. And then you can click on property and you can change that. You can add text, include, you can add text right here. And there are other options also. We will just click on it. And here you can see, let's again go to settings and just click it. We will delete it. We will again click on define factor of safety plot, and we will not uncheck it. Previously we unchecked it, that's why it was showing 3 only. And if we just click OK, you can see here the factor of safety distribution, minimum factor of safety for the model is 43. This is quite higher factor of safety. So for tensile strength of 11,000 newton, if we apply, the factor of safety will be 43 times. So this is factor of safety plotting for you guys. And the next is we will talk about the fatigue plotting. To show fatigue plotting, we will right click on it right here, and let's just click show this, and we will right click on it and we will click here. You can see define fatigue check plotting, so we will click on it. Here you can see the first one is loading type. So if we The first one is on or offloading. It is here. You can, if you take a look at this figure right here, it is showing us that the load will be oscillated between 0 to 11,000 newton. If you check this, and if we check this right here, it will, the load will be oscillating from -11,000 newton to +11,000 newton. So we don't want minus loading right here. We will click on this start right here, and then the next option is surface finish factor. So we will click on it and we will click it machined, and we will keep the loading factor and the size factor by default what it is showing. We will just, let's keep it axial, and then let's click OK. So as you can see, the whole model is showing blue color here. So we, if we had any fatigue for 11,000 newton on this model, we may have the red areas, but we don't have any fatigue right here for this load right here. So it is showing us blue. And as we previously checked, the factor of safety is 43 for this load. So it will not happen it will cause no fatigue. This load will not cause no fatigue. This is just the common sense right here, we can see. So this is all about showing fatigue or fatigue plot or factor of safety plot or strain plot. So these are just different method of showing your result. And then just click on show right here, and if we right click on result right here, and then we click on solver message here, solver message does, it shows us the number of nodes are available in this model right here, the number of elements are created by machine. We will save this as Excel file. We will need this in our, we will save this solver message one. Okay, let's just save it. We will require this to compare the result when we will apply different size of element. When we apply different size of element for meshing this model, and the difference between the node number, the stress, and the strain, and the displacement will be different if we apply different different size of mesh right here. So this is all for today, guys. We will talk about how we can compare this result with other results when we will decrease or increase the mesh, the element of mesh, and we will compare these values with coarser mesh or finer mesh in our next lectures. Till then, thank you. I will catch you in the next one.